Hey guys, welcome back to our second installment of our short series of seven habits of highly effective teens. So we're just gonna jump right into it, no intro, no nothing. So we're going into habit four. Habit four, five, six is under the public victory section. So what this means is this is really dealing with other people. So this is about collaboration, this is about teamwork, all that kind of stuff. And the biggest rule about the public victory is master the private victory first and then come here, because that's what I talked about in the other video, because it all begins with you. So habits 1, 2, 3, just to refresh, were habit 1 was to be proactive, habit 2 was to begin with the end in mind, and habit 3 was to put first things first. These are all things that you do by yourself, and once you've gotten those solid, we're here for the next set, which is 4, 5, and 6. So habit 4 is think win-win. So habit 4 teaches us, just because we win, someone else doesn't have to lose. And there are four attitudes that is highlighted in this chapter. One is the win-lose totem pole. This is always saying that the pie of success is only so big. So if you get a big piece, there's only less for me. So basically, everybody can't win. Either I get it or you get it. And this really kind of ruins friendships, and this type of attitude puts friendships and loyalty only second to winning. So they're willing to do whatever it takes to win. The second type is lose win, which is the doormat type. This is really where, you know, you get your way with me always. I'm not going to stand up for myself. And this can be just as dangerous as win lose. Even though it might look humble on the surface, it's really hurting your self-esteem, and it's really easy to get stepped on by other people. And with this type of attitude, you'll always let the other person get their way, which means you'll set low expectations and compromise always. The third type is lose-lose, which is called the downward spiral. This attitude says, if I'm going down, you're going down with me. And everybody has a bit of all these types of attitudes at some point in their lives. And this is really surrounded around the principle that misery loves company. So if you want to do, if you're going down, you want to pull other people down in there. And when you, and another form of this is revenge. And you know, I'm bad with this too. I'm sure everybody has trouble with it. But even when you get revenge, you might think you're winning, but all you're doing is really hurting yourself. And this scenario is extremely common when two win-win people come together, because, or two win-lose people come together, because both of them want to win, and then they both end up losing. And then the last one is win-win, the all-you-can-eat buffet. This is, there's unlimited winning stuff for everybody, and this is the belief that everybody can win. You can be both nice and tough at the same time. This is like, I won't step on you, but I won't be your doormat either. And this is when you have happiness in other people and you want them to succeed, but you also care about yourself and want yourself to succeed. It's not either you or me, it's both of us. So that's what is really highlighted in habit 4. Habit 5 is seek first to understand, then to be understood. So there's two parts to this. The first one is to understand. So listen. Everybody is a horrible listener, and it really says you have two ears and one mouth. Listen more, talk less. And this is probably the worst habit for me, because I'm a big talker, but I don't pay attention and listen as well. So yeah. So first, understand people's needs and give them a solution. So this book is filled with small stories and anecdotes and experiences that the author has and other philosophers, other people write. And they're really good, actually. They talk about like people going into a store to buy a phone, and before even listening to your needs, people are giving you, you know, the salesperson is just trying to get you to buy something, and it's really saying listening is the first part. And there's many different types of bad listening, like spacing out, where we're just in a different galaxy and we just completely ignore them. Pretend listening, where we're just like, put in some quick things in there, some quick comments to make them think you're listening, but you're really not. Selective listening, where you're only listening to the words that interest you, and you're not really listening to the whole thing. And then self-centered listening is where it's all about you. You take things from your perspective. This is kind of a little confusing for me, but yeah, you're always trying to see everything from our point of view. And the biggest thing about this is we always do three things when we listen from our point of view. We either judge, we advise, or we probe. And then the last type is word listening, which they say can be really bad, which all we do is pay attention to their words, not their tone, their body language, their feelings. And that makes it really bland, and we're not able to understand the deeper emotions that they're trying to convey. And the second part, and the best way to listen, is genuine listening. And I'm not sure I really agree with this, but I'm just saying what the book says. So it says 53% of listening, or of somebody talking, 53% is body language, 40% is tone and feeling, and only 7% is words. I think words should be a little higher than 7%, but the book says it only matters this much. The biggest thing is how you present it and all that. And then the second part of this is first seek first to understand, then to be understood. So after this, you need to take the courage and go out and make other people understand your point of view. The first one might be easier for like introverts, but if you are someone like that, it's going to be harder for you to speak up. And in a poll done here, the guy, Sean Covey, he did a poll with people, and he said to ask people what their biggest fear was. And death only came second. The first biggest fear of people was public speaking, which is crazy. But yeah, so make sure you get other people to understand you and stay bold and courageous and yeah, talk to others. Then the habit six is synergize. This is alone we can do so much, but together we can do so much more, which is a quote by Helen Keller. And this is really highlighted in the story of geese. So geese always fly in their V formation. And the reason they do this is they can fly 71% farther than if each bird flew alone. This is because when each goose flies, the updrift of his wings like makes the other person go faster and faster and faster. And whenever you hear the geese honking, it's like encouraging the bird in the front to go faster. And since the bird in the front doesn't get any updrift, whenever he gets tired, he goes to the back of the V and a new guy comes there. And it was just showing how much teamwork they have and how they can fly 71% farther than if they were to fly themselves. Now, synergy is really celebrating differences, teamwork, open-mindedness, finding new and better ways. And synergy is not just tolerating differences or working independently or thinking you're always right or compromising. And the thing is, the reason people don't celebrate differences is mainly because of cliches, ignorance, and prejudice. This video is going to be really, really long if I went into each of these things. So I'm not going to. You should definitely go actually read the book instead of just listening to my short video, which just skims the surface of the book. And then it shows that synergy is really the higher way, which means it's like better than each of the people can do by themselves. So it shows compromise is 1 + 1 = 1.5. Cooperation is 1 + 1 = 2. But synergy is 1 + 1 = 3, which is better than, and you might be like, what? But it's like a better way than if each of you were supposed to do it. Because when the teamwork comes, you create a better product. And it was saying 1 2x4 beam, and builders know this very well, because 1 2x4 beam can support 607 pounds. So you might think that two beams would be able to support 1,214 pounds, but no, when they come together, it can actually support 1,821 pounds. So that's where you really see synergy coming into the place. Now, the last one is sharpen the saw. And this final habit is all about renewing yourself, renewing your body, your brain, your heart, and your soul. If you forget each one of these, if you're all about perfecting your body, but you don't care about your mind and heart, you're not going to succeed. So it's keeping everything in balance. And as the ancient Greek saying, nothing over much, which reminds us to take everything in moderation and make time to relax and take care of yourself, which is really about sharpening the saw. And the story he says in this is, you see a person when you're walking through the forest and you ask what he's doing. And he says, I'm sawing down a tree. And he says, how long have you been at it? And he says, I've been at it for about 4 hours, but I'm making a lot of progress. So you ask, why don't you just take 15 minutes to sharpen the saw so you can go 3 times as fast? And he goes, I can't, you idiot. I'm too busy sawing. So this really shows that if he had just taken the small time to sharpen it up and get it ready, he would have probably done it way, way faster than if he was just going at it with a dull saw. So yeah, this is really about renewing yourself and self-care. And this is really about sharpening your skills. And it's about all the other habits we've learned. So habit 7 is not really under the public victory. It's just kind of by itself. It's in the renewal section. So yeah, that's basically it, guys. Those are all the 7 habits. There's a lot of stuff like the personal bank account, the relationship bank account, so much of other stuff in this book. It took me time to read, but I'm so glad that I read it. You should definitely read it. Well, that's been it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching till the end. And yep, that's it. I'll catch you next one. Bye.